safari, safari. Safari twaenda leo. Safari twaenda. Tusonga. Tufike.
Barabara zimeundwa. Hapo hatutasema uongo. Barabara zimeundwa kuundwa kwa sababu hata unakuta zile barabara tulikuwa tunaenda mingi tunachukua masaa mengi kuenda huko. Sasa ni madakika kwa sababu kuna traffic lights na barabara ni nyewe zinaenda.
Road infrastructure is basically the most important issue, you know, facing the entire country. We have approached the entire country, all the counties without exception, the 47 counties. We have gone to every county and we have a catalog which is alphabetical, starting from Baringo to West Pokot, to make sure nobody is left behind. Secondly, we've done a lot of public participation to make sure there is public ownership of what we are doing. Because the roads require acquisition of land, it requires creation of corridor by destroying some properties along the way. So we must get public ownership. And so we have engaged the public as required by the Constitution 2010, and that has also helped us a lot. And then thirdly, we have had a lot of political support, all the way from the top. The president has been actually a champion of this particular program. And with him coming on board, we've had also leaders, members of parliament, you know, senators helping us in terms of getting budgets approved to make sure there is expeditious completion of these roads with adequate budgetary allocations. And then fourthly, we've also had a lot of donor support, because donors, they go to where they can see action. So we've had very diverse group of donors coming to support some of the very key road programs which you've had. So a combination of all those factors is what has brought success. And then finally we've got the concept of the low volume program, which targets areas for development, taking into account the volumes of traffic going through those areas, and therefore becomes very cost effective. And I'm so happy to note that as of now, we've done 9,500 kilometers.
Across all counties, roadworks are being carried out in urban areas under the supervision of Kenya Urban Roads Authority to facilitate urban mobility and improve the motorist and pedestrian experience and increase efficiency.
Kura has built an overall investment on roads values about 259 billion. Kenya shillings. That is a lot. 259 billion shillings worth of roads.
We started by expanding our junctions and most of them eliminating what we call right turns as much as possible. We are able to expand and reduce traffic jams in several roads in town. One of the key roads we did was Gong Road and other areas, and that measure is still continuing. In the medium term, we have realized that we also need to expand our roads. We need to increase the capacity of roads we have in our cities and towns. For example, if you look at Nairobi, we have been implementing a lot of projects by putting up new roads, dwarfing other roads, and we have done a lot of identified a lot of missing links which are going to increase traffic flow. If you go to the long term, we are now doing road bypasses across towns, because we realize that most of the traffic which comes to town, there is no purpose in town, so we have diverted away from town. We have done bypasses, the eastern northern bypasses. We have done the Meru bypasses to decongest Meru town. We are now doing Kisi bypass to decongest Kisi town. So in the long term, we are trying to eliminate a lot of traffic coming into town. Another long-term measure we are trying to do is now to leverage on the issue of technology. We have introduced what we call the intelligent transportation system. What we are doing is that we are installing traffic signals at junctions which are intelligent. They can manage the traffic flow across the junction automatically. They do it real time. What they normally do technically is that if one arm of the junction is congested and it was given less time, in the next cycle they'll give it more time so that more traffic can be able to pass through the junction.
In various urban areas in the country, there has been an upshot of the construction of bypasses and link roads in order to ensure ease of transport.
These bypasses, in most of the centers we are doing, it is a way in which we are expanding that town to realize its full potential and make sure the investment is evenly spread out.
Before the construction of the bypasses and link roads, road users across the country in urban areas used to contend with traffic gridlock for hours on end. Man hours were wasted meanwhile, operation and transport costs increased.
Tunatumia transport pesa nyingi sana kwa kufikisha samaki town.
However, these bypasses and link road projects are due to change all that as we go forth on our mission to actualize Vision 2030 and the Big Four agenda.
In terms of food security, of course, most of the farming production of food is done in the rural areas, but this food it finds its market in urban areas. So as Kura, what we do is that we provide accesses to marketplaces.
Hiyo barabara mpya ijengwe imesaidia sana. Sasa sasa sisi vitu yetu ina kujiangwa hapa inaenda Moyale, inaenda Marsabit, sisi ndio tunalisha watu huko. Huko inchikafu huko.
In terms of affordable housing, of course we are doing roads, access road to estates. We are doing access roads to all towns. What we are doing is that we are opening up our towns by doing roads so that people can be able now to put up affordable housing. So the more housing we put, the more affordable it becomes. If you come to manufacturing is around the industrial areas. If you move the industrial areas around Nairobi, industrial area, the key roads there, that is Likoni Road, Enterprise Road, Rungarunga Road, we have all improved those roads to ensure that access to manufactured goods and access to the industries is improved. In terms of affordable health care, it is rather obvious. We focus on improvement of accesses to health facilities. Nairobi Hospital, it used to be very congested, and we took it upon ourselves to expand the road there so that traffic flow around that place is enhanced. Kenyatta Hospital is accessed through Ngong Road and Hospital Road. We make sure that all those roads are in good condition and traffic flows for emergencies and to make sure that for the comfort of our sick brothers and sisters.
Improved urban network attracts investment, creates opportunities, improves security and increases human dignity. It is for this reason that the demand for road infrastructure cannot be matched. Some of these benefits have been realized as the multiplier of effects of link roads has led to the expansion of urban network and creation of opportunities along several bypasses across the city.
You can see what is happening on Eastern Bypass. It has become a hub, an industrial and commercial hub of its own kind. It has created immense employment for our youth. It has all kinds of activities along this road have come up until within no time after opening, we started now planning for its expansion.
The implementation of these strategies has not been without its challenges.
So one of the challenges you're having is the management of traffic when we are working. We are forced to inconvenience other developments or other people along the road. Another challenge you are facing is inadequate financing for maintenance, for development, and even for rehabilitation of the roads. We find that there's a lot of maintenance backlog. I think there was a time when maintenance was not very well structured, so the many roads were left unmaintained. And as you maintain those roads, you need to develop more roads. Another challenge which we face is that we have to share our road corridor with other users who are not actually returned to mobility. Another challenge is also sometimes you need to acquire land. If you have to change over, we have to implement our designs, and land in Kenya, especially in urban areas, is very, very expensive. The cost of implementing the project is almost as equal as the cost of the land you are buying.
All over the country, Kura has collaborated with county governments, public institutions, and other stakeholders to ensure improvement of road networks.
We have what we call national urban roads, which are supposed to be done by Kura. We have county roads, which are supposed to be done by the county governments. So we normally share our plans with the county governments, tell them this is what we want to do. Sometimes they tell us, no, you see that road, even if it's a Kura road, it may not be a priority at the moment. So can you assist us do this with the resources you have? So we talk to them and we agree. We sign MOUs and we are able to work together and to optimize on the resources.
We have areas like even police stations, we have hospitals. We have collaborated with them to convenience access to their places. And whenever we are planning a road that traverses these areas, we must do extensive consultation. We must have a stakeholder input for us to be effective as an urban area. We also deal with neighborhoods. We want to convenience this mobility and access in these neighborhoods.
In Nairobi, Kura has set out to construct a web of interconnected roads all around the city that ensure a road user can move from one end of the city to the other without using the conventional roads. One of these link roads is the Wayakiwe Red Hill Link Road.
Westlands is like now another CBD. There's a lot of development there. And what we are doing with the link road is that we are now trying to bypass Westlands. If you're coming from the Limuru side, you're coming from the United Nations offices, you are able not to avoid the traffic jam through Westlands and quickly connect through the Red Hill Link, Wayaki Link to Wayaki Road. You can now join Kilimani, Ravington area, and go to other areas of Nairobi.
The Wayakiwe Red Hill Link Road was commenced in early 2016 and is now done. Other major projects that Kura has done include the upgrading of roads in all county headquarters in the country. These include Eldoret Town, Mokoi in Lamu County, Garissa Town, Mandera Town, Wajir, Mararal Town, Kapenguria Town, Kisi Town, Chuka Town, Wote Town, Isiolo Town and Marsabit Town, among others. Kura is all about the future of urban transportation.
Our next step is to decongest Nairobi in terms of economic development. How do you do that? We now empower other big towns to do development. That's why we are now focusing our presence in all county headquarters. So that, you know, initially everybody used to come and have a business in Nairobi. That's why the appetite is, because that's where more people are. But with the devolution, we have the county headquarters, we have come on board. Most of them did not even have any infrastructure. I can give an example of Mandera. Mandera is a county headquarters. It didn't even have a single tarmac. But when it came on board, we are now doing some work there. And also Turkana was the same, did not have even a single tarmac. But when we came on board, we did some development of roads there. You have to create smart cities, and Nairobi is one of them. You cannot sit down and say you just construct roads without also getting the issue of technology. And with the one government approach, that's why I was talking about the intelligent traffic management system, management of security and all that. So in summary, we will also leverage on technology to ensure that our towns and cities are smart.
After all is said and done, the goal is seamless connectivity on urban areas as we move towards increasing the population served by urban network, taking you from one point to the next with minimal fuss and into the future, seamlessly.